garbage dressed up three different ways. Now pay close attention here. So I want to talk about the dragon, the beast, and the false prophet tonight, all right? Now, does anybody know who the beast is? Beast right there is the papacy. Anybody know who the false prophet is? False prophets, apostate Protestantism. Those so-called Protestant churches which do not keep God's law, which reject the fullness of God's truth. They say solo scriptura, but what happened to the Sabbath? You know what I'm talking about?
Yes, sir.
All right. And that beast is what we're talking about, like I said, is the papacy, the same papacy that's found within, that same beast that's found within Revelation chapter 13, starting at verse 1, all the way through. However, I want us to talk about the dragon tonight. Because, you know, it's always so interesting to me. Everybody's always ready to put their claws into the papacy. And rightfully so, because the scriptures gets their claws into it too.
That's right.
And we can clearly see that these brothers over there, you know, some of these evangelicals, truly are not upholding the standard of the Word of God. But what's so interesting to me is how most the majority of us are getting swept by the dragon.
Yes.
Now, what's the dragon a symbol of right here? Do you know?
Pagan Rome.
Somebody say pagan Rome. Somebody said Satan. This dragon is a symbol of paganism. Let me go into this with you. Now let's first go. The dragon primarily is a symbol of the devil, and we can look at that from the book of Revelation chapter 12. Turn your Bibles there. Revelation chapter 12 and verse 9. Revelation chapter 12 and verse 9. You have it, say amen.
Amen.
We're not going to stay here all night long, but we're going to get through the message. Revelation chapter 12 and verse 9. Now you see what it says there. See what it says there?
Yes, sir.
It says that great dragon.
Yes, was cast out.
That was cast out. The old serpent called the what? Devil and Satan. He was cast out into the earth, who deceived the whole world, rather. He was cast out into the earth, and his angels were cast out with him. The dragon is a symbol of whom there?
The devil.
The devil. Clearly from the scriptures we see that the dragon is a symbol of the devil. Yes. However, look at the book of Revelation chapter 12, starting at verse 3. Revelation chapter 12, starting at verse 3. When we have it, say amen.
Amen.
Now look what it says there. And I saw, and there appeared another wonder in heaven. Behold, a great red dragon having seven heads and ten horns, and upon its head, what?
Seven
and seven crowns upon its heads. And it says, and his tail drew a third of the stars of what?
Heaven.
And did what? Cast them where?
Heaven.
To the earth. And the dragon stood before the woman to devour her child as soon as what?
It was born.
Let's stop right there. Now, who is that child that was coming forth out of the woman? Now, we learned earlier this week that that woman was God's church. We learned earlier this week that that man child that was coming forth out of the woman was Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Now, the next question is, did we see anywhere in the scriptures that Satan is a seven-headed dragon standing in front of Mary to devour Jesus as soon as he came out of her womb?
No.
We never saw no such thing. However, if you turn your Bible to the book of Matthew chapter 4 and verse 16. Matthew chapter 4 and verse 16, you do see something there. Matthew chapter 4 and verse 16. Matter of fact, I'm sorry, chapter 2 and verse 16. Matthew chapter 2 and verse 16. Are you there?
Yeah.
Chapter 2. Now it says there, then Herod, when he saw that he was mocked of the wise men that came and were asking about the star that was leading them, and they knew that it was the star that indicated that the coming of the Messiah was there. It said, then Herod, when he saw he was mocked of the wise men, was exceeding wroth and sent forth and slew all the children, where? That were in Bethlehem and in all the coast thereof from 2 years old and under, according to the time which he had diligently acquired of the wise men. Herod, acting as an agent of the devil, made a decree for the children in the land of a certain age to be wiped out in an effort to destroy the Messiah, Jesus Christ. Herod was the leader of what nation? Pagan Rome. Showing us here clearly in the scriptures that the devil has worked through earthly governments to carry out his specific designs in this earth. You see that? The dragon is also a symbol of pagan Rome. But it's not just a symbol of pagan Rome. I want you to see this clearly, what I'm talking about. Turn your Bible to the book of Ezekiel, chapter 29 and verse 3. Ezekiel chapter 29 and verse 3. When you have it, say amen. You there? Ezekiel chapter 29 and verse 3. Amen. You there? Now let's look what it says there. Speak thou and say, thus saith the Lord. Behold, I'm against thee, Pharaoh, king of Egypt, what? The great dragon that lieth in the midst of the rivers, which have said, my rivers are mine own, what? I have made them for myself. One second. Notice here that God calls Pharaoh, the king of Egypt, the great dragon now. When you look at both of the examples that we just observed from the scriptures, you see something clearly. The devil has worked through government structures on this earth. And these governments have played a key role in rejecting the worship of the true and living God and persecuting God's people. Is that true or false? Egypt is guilty of persecuting God's people and rejecting the worship of the true and living God. Pagan Rome was guilty of rejecting the true and living God and persecuting those who would worship God according to his commandments. Both pagan government systems, and not only were they pagan government structures, but these pagan governments developed social systems that educated the individuals that were integrated into those social systems to reject the true and living God themselves as well. Because when Pharaoh rejected God and refused to listen to Moses and to let the children of Israel go, you didn't hear the rest of Egypt quailing and being upset, because they were right behind their God, Pharaoh. When Nero was persecuting the Christians, you never heard the pagan Roman Empire in an uproar. They were in the Colosseums cheering for the Christians to be burned. Yes. Because the dragon government system is not only a pagan system, but it breeds pagans. You didn't hear that, right?
Yes.
Now, why is that important? Well, you remember you just read a few minutes ago in Revelations chapter 12, 13 and verse 11, right? And I saw another beast come up out of the earth. He had two horns like a lamb, but what did he do? What did he do? He spake as a dragon. What country is that? The U.S. You got what I'm just talking about right now?
Yes.
It means it will speak as a dragon. How does a nation speak? Through its judicial officials, through its courts, and it sets up laws. It controls your school systems. Did you hear what I said?
Yes,
it controls the parameters of the society in which you live, and the dragon always builds a society that produces pagans.
Wow.
You heard that? That's where you live. That's where I live. Why is that important for us to understand? Because, brothers and sisters, we were told clearly in the scriptures earlier in Revelation 16 and verse 13, there is a movement going forth to deceive us, to gather us together for the purpose of rebelling in opposition to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And it's not a forceful movement. It's not a forceful effort that's being made right now. It's an effort being made through education. The pushing of ideologies.
Yes.
That's why the unclean spirits are coming out of their mouths.
Verse.
Educating you to rebel against God.